were designed to be the best. They met enemies face to face, endured tragedies and enjoyed victories. They went down in history due to the bravery of their crews. They are the ships that deserve to be called naval legends. Town Yokosuka, 62 miles away from Tokyo, battleship Mikasa is permanently anchored, and 4,000 marine miles away from her, cruiser Aurora is anchored in one of the quays of the Neva River in St. Petersburg. Although these ships belong to different types and their stories are very different, there is a common moment in their biography. Both ships participated in a major naval battle, the Battle of Tsushima. It was the culmination of the Russo-Japanese War in the beginning of the 20th century. In 1895, Japan defeated China and occupied the Liaodong Peninsula, where a warm water seaport, Port Arthur, was located. The port was very important for the Russian Empire. Together with European states, Russia used military and political pressure to make Japan renounce that peninsula, and later signed a contract of lease for that territory with China for 25 years.
Using the opportunity of the Yihetuan movement, also known as the Boxer Rebellion, Russia expanded into Manchuria and Korea. The Japanese were very worried by the expansion policy and decided to start preparations to reinforce their fleet.
Within 7 years, the Japanese fleet was reinforced by four new cruisers and four battleships. Battleship Mikasa, built in British dockyards, became the most powerful new ship of the Land of the Rising Sun. The Aurora was built in Russia during the same period. This was just a small part of a large-scale program aimed at enhancing the country's military potential at sea, the creation of the major Pacific Fleet. But they failed to fully implement the program. On February the 9th, 1904, Japanese ships attacked Russian fleet near Port Arthur. They also attacked cruiser Varian and gunboat Koryets in the Korean port Chemulpo. The Russo-Japanese War began.